Yeah, you better have a good time, lady. Because your good times are coming to an immediate end.
What an entrance.
What a dress. Why does that dress look so familiar to me?
Well, I can explain.
Nancy, isn't that your dress?
It used to be. I made a few alterations.
With what, a machete?
I'm sorry, Cassie. Ace has confiscated all my clothes. He canceled my credit. I'll make it up to you, I promise. Forget it, forget it. It's just a dress. And you are just an angel. Love you.
Well, I guess it could be worse. You could have cut up your drapes.
Oh, Andrew, stop. I know you don't approve of Blair, but she's my only cousin. I mean, she's family, and I never had much in the way of family.
Well, you do now. I'm going to tell Luna to play Lady in Red.
No, you are not.
Oops. Well, it's perfect. Lady in Red, honey. You okay?
Lady in Red.
No, it's just...
Hey, no. That's the thing you want to say to me, Kane? To my face for a change?
Well, Blair, you're very good at sneaking up on people, aren't you?
Oh, I've got nothing to hide. Back in this dress, I wouldn't even dream of trying. How about you, Kane? Everything you say is a lie.
What is that expression, the pot calling the kettle black?
Every step I take, I run into one of your cheap little tricks, canceling my credit cards, paying a stop on my bank account.
Mm, your credit card. Well, listen, Blair, why don't you just go talk to all your friends here, huh? And instead of bothering Tina and me?
Is this really what you want out of life, Tina? Ace's bag man in your bed? This certainly beats waiting tables, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Hey, Buchanan, you know that guy?
Yeah, I know.
What a turkey. My friend just took him for 75 bucks at pool. Thought he was a real hustler. That's a major fox he's dancing with.
Hey, watch. I used to be married to that fox.
Oh, right, and I used to be Ulysses S. Grant.
I'm serious. It's Leanne Demarest. She's the mother of my son.
Dance with me?
Hey, Rachel. I'll see you later, pal.
Wait a minute. We were just in the middle of your life story.
Well, let's just say I'm working on the sequel.
This is sound a little crazy.
It won't be the first time, sure.
But I can't help but feel a little sorry for Blair.
You're right. That sounds crazy.
No, wait. But what I'm trying to say is that Addie's Blair's whole life. Addie's the heart of Blair, and then to steal her like that.
You may be right, Max. But when it comes to goodwill, Blair has used up her chances, at least.
How about you? Has Blair used up her chances with you? All right, forget about it. I don't want to know whatever you and Blair did to make Ace so jealous that he closed Serenity Springs. You did it, and it's done with, and I don't want to know about it. Not now, not ever. Well, are we going to dance or not, General?
I have to get a message to Andrew. Will you excuse me?
Oh, I'll save a place on my dance card. I hope I didn't interrupt anything.
You know, Dorian, you say that so often. You should have it put on a T-shirt.
Oh, no, that's not very nice, Vicky. Although I realize you're in a bad mood.
Being around you tends to do that.
Do I detect a nasty note in that mainline manner?
Oh, Dorian, I am so tired of your very tired tricks.
Excuse me, I'm here to enjoy myself.
How? By needling me and goading me? By cozying up to Sloane so that I'll fly into a jealous rage? Sorry, madam. So sorry to disappoint you, but I will never be jealous of you. How could I possibly be jealous of someone for whom I haven't an ounce of respect?
The lady doth protest too much.
The lady's got news for you. Whatever it is you are trying to accomplish, it's not working.
Are we quite sure of that? Queen Victoria.
I don't even know you. Well, this is a fine way to bring in the new year.
Sure is.
I mean, at least at the dance there was an acre of food. Oh, I'm starved.
Well, Edgar, do you want a breath mint? Oh, look. I'm really sorry about all of this.
Oh, that's right.
No, I mean it. I saw that car go up over the curb, and I thought, you know, that crazy drunk is going to kill someone. Then I went a little crazy myself.
Yeah. You might want to watch that.
Well, yeah, I'm trying to, but until I find the guy responsible for Sarah's death, I've just got too much rage inside me.
I know, Bo. I understand.
Jamtown ladies, sing this song. Hoo-ha, hoo-ha, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, all the hoo-ha day.
You know what? It's not hoo-ha. It's doo-dah. Not hoo-ha, doo-dah. All the doo-dah day. Right?
That's what I said. Hoo-ha.
You can't correct my husband. Your husband? Sure I can. It's doo-dah.
Easy,
I'm tired. Mom. I'm hungry. I hate people who mess up lyrics. Hank used to do that all the time. It drove me crazy.
Hey, keep it down in here.
No. You know what? We're tired of keeping it down in here. We demand to be arraigned and processed and released on our own recognizance with due process.
You demand?
Yes.
You keep up your demanding, lady, and you and your friend here are going to spend the night in the tank.
You're kidding.
Do I look like I'm kidding?
Renee may have said no to Mortimer, but she'll say yes to Carlo. It's me. You're not Renee.
No, I'm not.
Excuse me, please. I'd like to leave a message for Mrs. Buchanan, Mrs. Renee Buchanan.
Certainly.
Would you tell her, please, that a friend was looking for her? A friend from the past.
Sweet.
I'll give you that. Baby, come on. Let's not fight, okay? As it is, I still have to go to the precinct party pretty soon.
Oh, no. On New Year's?
Want to go with me?
Oh, I have to go to the precinct party at Christmas?
Yeah.
You know, I think you have to be a cop to get the jokes, though, dear. You go yourself. I will wait here for
you. Okay.
I love this kind of music, don't you?
Yeah.
It reminds me of those women with seams in their stockings waiting for the boys to come home.
You know, we could sort of go with that later if you want. I could run a World War II uniform and you could pile that hair up.
Stop.
Can I ask you something, Ms. Gannon?
Yes, Mr. Buchanan.
No, seriously, no. Any plans for later on this evening?
No. No plans.
You think maybe you and I could spend some time together? Alone? Excuse me, sweetheart. Excuse me. May I dance with my daughter?
Sure.
Thank you.
Hi. Well, they look pretty good together, don't they?
Yeah, the chip and the block.
No, I mean, sometimes I'm even wondering if it's even possible for you to change, even if you want to.
Of course it's possible, Tina. But you made me a promise that if I made a New Year's resolution, you would believe me.
I know what I promised.
Well, New Year's Eve is not over yet, and in my book, a promise is a promise. Wait here, right? Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Thanks. I, Kane Rogan, being of sound mind and body on this New Year's Eve, hereby do declare that I'm a changed man. Made many mistakes, done many wrongs, but I never realized how much I could hurt people. And I'm a human being, and human beings make mistakes. They're not perfect. Nothing is. Except my love for Tina Roberts. I love Tina with all my heart and all my soul. She has, she's brought out part in me that, well, nobody, not even I, knew was there. Well, Tina, you made me a promise. I'm gonna make you one. I'm gonna be that man that I wanna be, the man that you want. And if you just give me a chance, you won't be sorry.
That was touching, wasn't it?
Touching. A blowtorch couldn't touch you. Oh, by the way, I'm divorcing you on grounds of adultery. I'm naming Max Holden as correspondent.
Dance. You used to dance a lot with me at Rhodey's.
Oh, well, you don't really dance to a slow tune. I just held you in my arms and walked in a circle.
Oh, come on.
Oh.
You are terrific.
I forgot. I gotta find this guy, Kane Rogan, friend of Luna's. Tina wanted me to give him a message. Don't you go away.
You still like the rough trade, Marty?
Oh, it's you. No, Doug, I still like dumb college boys who need their fannies wiped by their mommies.
Now, I'm no boy. You want me to show you?
Get lost! Get lost!
You better run along now, frat boy. You got it?
You let me know when you're through slumming, Marty.
You just love that, don't you? Luring him in like a bear to honey.
Go run your errand for Luna's friend.
Yeah, well, I've been trying to, but you keep
guys,
getting it.
You see Tina
Rogan.
They're looking for her everywhere. Do you know who she is?
Well, she's been looking for you. In fact, I got something for you. She said, look in the personals.
It's no way to kiss off a guy, huh?
Sorry, pal. Listen. You want to do a little bit more of that dancing stuff?
Enjoy yourselves. Single white female gourmet cook seeks man with great appetite. Outdoor woman looking for indoor man. No?
You get one of your superiors in here this minute, or I will file suit with the Landview Police Department for so much money that you will be driving this year's squad cars in the year 2093. Do you understand?
All right. All right.
Boy, you sure told him, huh? Just wonder if he was listening. Look, do you want another breath, man?
It's those two over there, sir.
Oh, great. My ex-wife. Nora, what the hell are you doing here?
Adultery? Asa, I don't know what you're talking about. What happened between Max and me took place before you and I were married. That does not constitute adultery.
You're starting to believe your own lies, you witch. But I have witnesses to know about your nightly secret rendezvous with Max. People who saw you getting it on with Max in the woods, Serenity Springs. It smells of adultery to me.
Now, I don't know what people you're talking about, but this sounds like the only lies here are the ones being spoon-fed to you by Kane Rogan.
All right. Pick on poor Kane for a change.
Wait a minute, Asa. One more thing. Even if it were true about the adultery, don't tell me the great Asa Buchanan wants to tell the world he's been cuckolded. I mean, wouldn't that be a sight? Asa the dupe, compliments of Max Holden.
If I could get rid of the likes of you, I would wear horns in hell, even dance with them in the street on my head.
Oh, really? Well, put on your dancing shoes, Asa. I think I hear our song coming on. I've got a question for the love line, may I, Luna? Love line, maybe you could help me. What would you say about a young woman who was blackmailed into marriage by this very rich and very dirty old man? Even though she was madly in love with another man, a good man, a man who knew how to make her feel like a woman. And then on the day of her marriage to this old man, she and the man she truly loved made wild, passionate love right on top of her wedding dress. Oh, yes, folks, only hours before she walked down the aisle. Was that wrong, love line? I ask you.
If I were Asa right now, I would burrow under the floor.
Well, it's certainly nice to see Asa take a lick for once in his life.
That was no lick. It was more like a direct shot to the jugular.
Jimmy was killed by his own mother while she was driving drunk. Drunk drivers who killed their own children on the next open.
Today at 4, right here on Channel 7. Be a wheel watcher.
Tonight at 7:30, right here on Channel 7.
Hello? Do you have the key to room number, let's see here,
322. That's an interesting system you have there.
Yes, it is. Rather lightweight, easily transported, and if you're in the army overseas during wartime, makes you very popular.
You must be Mr. Rogan.
In fact, tonight, I am.
This is for you. Now you have a matched set.
Thank you very much, and Happy New Year. Tina, you have made my day, my year, my life.
I can't believe she did that.
Poor Asa. Clint, what should we do? We can't just let him stand there like that.
Asa. Ladies and gentlemen, please, if I can have your attention. I think that you know that our lovely love line star, Ms. Luna Moody, is a true daughter of the South. Well, when she came to Landview, she brought with her a time-honored New Year's tradition.
I think you've all been given a delicious chocolate chip cookie. Now, please don't eat it yet, because hidden in one of those cookies, and only one, is a big old cranberry bean. Really, a cranberry bean. Now, please, whoever is lucky enough to find that bean will be crowned with his or her partner, New Year's Queen and King. So, all together now, are we ready? Let's start the great cranberry search. One, two, go.
Can you look up?
I found it.
Hey! Hey!
I've never won the lottery. I've never won anything.
Well, now you want a bean. That's great.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do not think that in the history of this time-honored tradition we've ever had a more beautiful queen or handsome king than Leanne Demarest and Jason Webb. Da-da-da-da-da-da.
I like it.
Here you go, darling. Got it on?
Yep.
Now, if you please start and lead the royal dance. Thank you for the cookies. Yeah.
Thank you.
No, nothing.
Kiss me, my
Get back here, Hank.
Be mine.
This isn't where I was planning to be right now, listening to your sad story.
It wasn't exactly what I was planning either, Hank.
Well, that's your problem, isn't it? I didn't tell you to get involved with Mr. Buchanan here.
Oh, I'm not involved, Hank.
No, Nora was an innocent bystander. You got it all wrong.
No, you got it wrong. Now, you Buchanan, you think you can just go around and take the law into your own hands and do whatever you want to do.
Well, what do you want to see? Drunk drivers drive their cars up over curbs?
You know, it sounds to me, Hank, like when you're talking about Buchanan men doing whatever they want to do, that you're trying to settle some score or something that has nothing to do whatsoever with Beau.
And what is that supposed to mean?
I'm talking about Kevin, Buchanan, and Rachel.
There is no Kevin and Rachel. You understand?
Oh? Do they know about that?
Now, look here, Nora. I am here because you got yourself into a mess.
Oh, forget it, Hank. I don't want you to compromise yourself.
Let me get this straight. You two were married?
Tomorrow. Little, wait. Wait, please, look, I can explain, please.
You tell me the truth. Did you do what Blair said you did?
Just listen to me.
No. Did you sleep with her on her wedding day?
Yes, I did. I'm not going to lie to you. Listen to me. Now you know why Asa is so set on ruining my life and ruining yours,
Blair,
if we let him.
Yeah, he's got a damn good reason to want to ruin your life.
Well, maybe so, but you don't. Hey, would you look at me? Look at me! The last time I ever wanted Blair was that night at Serenity Springs in a hot tub. Do you remember that night? Well, that was a lifetime ago. Everything has changed since then. Everything. Darling, look at me. Look at me. I want you to know something. I don't want you to ever have to think about this again. That was the last time I ever wanted Blair. You're the one I love. And always will be. No one else. Ever. You hear me? Haven't you said enough already?
Listen to what they're playing. It's what we danced to this night just a year ago.
I don't care what they're playing. Do you realize what you did back there?
I did what I had to do. Max, listen. Won't you dance with me just for old time's sake? When you're the only one who's ever understood me, the only one who's ever cared about me, Max, please, just one dance.
I'm gonna go inside the ballroom.
Wait here.
Max, listen to me.
Haven't I heard enough already?
Why are you saying this? Don't you care at all about me? What about Addie? She loved you, and I thought you had feelings for her, too.
I do.
I know you do, Max, and that is one of the reasons that you were always so very special to me. You love Addie.
I'm going, Amy.
Stay.
You love Addie. And now Asa has, he's locked her up in St. Anne's Mental Hospital, and, what am I supposed to do when Asa steals my mother away? He is trying to destroy me. By destroying everybody that I care about, including you. Let's show him, Max. Let's show him. Just one dance. Come on. You remember last New Year's Eve? We couldn't stop dancing.
What's your name?
Blair Damon.
Suits you.
And you?
Max Holden.
Happy New Year, Mr. Holden. One more dance? What could be the harm?
No. No more dances. Not ever. I've saved all my dances for someone else. In the moody? May I have this dance?
Not so fast, you little tramp. You had your fun on the radio. Now I'm gonna have mine.
I'm a human being. You're a human being. Can we talk?
We've talked. There's nothing to talk about anymore, so sit down.
Come on, it's New Year's Eve. You know, peace on earth, goodwill towards men.
She'll be wearing 6x4.
No. It is she'll be driving 6x horses. You do not wear horses. You drive them.
That's what I was talking about, sir. Ever since she's got here, she's been complaining, making everybody's life miserable. I've never seen anything like it.
She comes.
I have. For 10 years.
I hate this place.
What? Oh, you look.
No.
What's the matter?
Happy New Year, boo. Asa, I can hardly wait for our day in court.
You sure are cocky. If someone's got as much to lose as you do.
You take whatever you want. Take it all. All I want is my freedom. The clothes on my back, a few dollars in my pocket. And Blair Daimler Designs.
Sorry, babe, you lose claim to that, too.
You wish. I own my company. I still control it.
Then you better learn to read. Like the small print in our agreement. It says, in the event of a divorce, and an event that's coming down the line real fast, the ownership of the company reverts to me. What's the matter, sweetheart? Huh?
You're lying.
Me lie? No. It's all there in black and white. Regret admitting what you said in a love line, do you?
The only thing I regret, Asa, is that I walked away when I thought you were dying. I should have stayed right there to make sure the job was done. Oh, but I have made a New Year's resolution, Asa. You just wait. I will get my revenge because you are not going to get me down. Nobody will. Because I am going to outlive and outlast all of you.
Renee,
thank you. Oh, thank you so much. This has been the best New Year's Eve of my entire life.
Oh, darling. I'm so happy for both of you. Enjoy yourself.
You.
Happy New Year, Renee. It's me. Carla.
No, no. This is a cruel, cruel trick.
Renee, Renee.
Oh, gosh. We can't miss this in here.
Don't worry about it. We got 17 seconds.
All right. All right.
Just think, this time next year, it'll almost be our first anniversary.
Andrew, I am so happy.
One year down, one year coming up. Let's count the old year down and out with Luna, all right? Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year!
We are going to get better, aren't we?
I've got a New Year's resolution for the people out there who are finding the road to romance to be a bumpy one.
You're shocked.
Hang in there, because you never know when you're going to find that man or the woman of your dreams. The trick is you just have to stick in there long enough with them so that they can realize what a pot of gold they have. All right, this is Luna Loveline Moody signing off for you sweethearts tonight.
This is Max Holden.
Happy New Year, lovers.
Valentine's Day I ever had. Let's go home.
You know what?
What?
You're the most lying man I ever met in my whole life. You know that?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Come on, Luna Moody. Make an honest man out of me. Take me home and lose your bet.
Let them tell me love's not worth going through.